What's going on, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Scott's Thoughts. Thank you for joining us. I like doing this stuff. It's super fun. Let's jump ahead to the Battle of Alberta. We had a good one last night. We had a big scrap, but let me set the stage beforehand. So Khaira, who plays for Edmonton, Michigan Tech alumni, shout out there. Good kid, good hockey player, left winger, big body, 6'4", 215 pounds. So he's, you know, he's a force. He lays the body on someone from Calgary. I'm not sure who. Everybody's up in arms about this hit. It was a dirty hit. He hit him in the head. First of all, it was a clean hit. Second of all, Khaira literally glides into him. Have you seen the old movie with Austin Powers? Older movie with Austin Powers when he's got the steamroller and the guy's like, no. And Austin Powers like, just get out of the way. Just get out of the way. That's what it was. Khaira slowly makes his way into the scrum, and the kid's got his head down looking for quarters for some odd reason. And he hits him. Like, where else is he going to hit him? He's got to hit him in the head, because that's the only place you can hit him, unless you slide in like a slip and slide, which is dangerous. So everyone's up in arms about this. It's a hit in the head. It's a hit in the head, blah, blah, blah. So that happens. The very next shift, Khaira jumps out. It's a defensive zone faceoff. Brett Ritchie jumps on the ice. He's like, I'm not going to let this stand. You hit my guy. I'm going to get some retribution. Let's do this. So they're in the D zone. One thing I always wondered, centermen take pride in their faceoff percentage. Before this fight, Khaira is a centerman. His centerman gets thrown out. Calgary centerman gets thrown out. Brett Ritchie steps in. They're jawing at each other. He's like, are we going to do this? Are we going to do this? Khaira's like, yes. Yeah, we're going to do it. Obviously, I know. These guys are not big fighters. They get into 2, 3, 4 fights a year. So this isn't what they do. They're strong. They're, you know, tough players, but they don't chuck them a lot. So Khaira's like, yeah, I'll fight you. Whatever. You're not Milan Lucic. So let's do this. So back to my thought. Is Khaira really trying to win the faceoff? Like, because that helps his stats, or is Ritchie trying to win the faceoff? I've always wondered this, because it's just one of those throwaway things that happens before a fight. It's like, who's going to win that faceoff? Because centermen take pride in their percentage. Anyways, the puck drops. Ritchie wins the draw, and they shed him. Okay, it's a typical square up. It's the Battle of Alberta. What are we going to do here? Khaira and Ritchie, they grab on. I like that. They both get a good grip. Here's where I think you notice Brett Ritchie's man strength. Khaira is a good, you know, he's a good, strong boy, but Brett Ritchie is a farm boy from Orangeville, Ontario. His brother Nick is an absolute moose out there. And you can just tell these guys are the same height, they're the same weight. Brett Ritchie's controlling this fight. It's a man strength type of thing happening here. And Khaira is a gamer. He buried someone from Ottawa last game. He stepped up to the plate, fought Gudbranson. Gudbranson's a big boy. He beat him up. Anyways, here we go. They start throwing. You can just tell right off the bat, Khaira's a little tentative. Richie's like, come on, throw a punch. They're both fighting tentative. Then all of a sudden, it's let's play chuck him. And they're going back and forth. Khaira slips and falls. He's off balance. Ritchie, I don't like the punches when he's on his knees. Not exactly a classy move, but if you're trying to get some retribution for a dirty hit, a perceived dirty hit on your team, I get it. I don't like it, but I understand. I'm not going to slight him for that. So Khaira falls. He takes a slip to a knee, and Ritchie just decides to start the lawnmower on when he's on the ice. He's going 1, 2, 3, 4 on the ice. Khaira finds his footing. He stands up, and he's like, I'm not going to take that. I'm going to just start swinging. He takes one big swing, and it's just lights out. And you see this happen, not the lights out part happen a lot, but where they both just take a big swing and one of them hits and one of them misses. You saw it a couple nights ago with Barclay Goodrow, and he fought that Ernie kid from Detroit. They both went for it. Goody landed and Ernie didn't. And then lights out. Good night, Irene. Down she goes. And this is what happened to Carr. They both just went. They brought the pants back and they came through, and Ritchie just landed solid. He rips the helmet off after the fight. That's always a classy move. You want the fans to see the hair, especially when you got a beautiful head of hair like that. We go back to Khaira, and this is scary. He doesn't know where he is. He doesn't know what's going on. His eyes are totally glossed over. He's still in la la land. He doesn't know what's going on. The trainer comes out. He's like, good fight. You lost. What are we going to do? Anyways, good fight all around. Ritchie is a tough son of a gun. He only fights 1 or 2 times a year. It's crazy. Khaira is getting helped off the ice. He's got Bambi legs. Tippett said after the game, he's feeling better. Hopefully he kind of gets back on the ice soon. Take care of that head, my man. He's a good hard-nosed player. Battle of Alberta. I love it. I want to see Zach Cassian back on the ice so he can kind of stick up for Edmonton. Because right now we got a Sutter coached Calgary Flames team who was just running roughshod through the North Division right now. They've changed their style of play. They got Zach Rinaldo. They got Milan Lucic. They got this Brett Ritchie. They're playing heavy hockey. Like I said a few episodes ago on my podcast, I like it. I like seeing it, and they're winning hockey games. Good night, Khaira. Good night, everybody. Thanks for listening. I will talk to you guys soon. Cheers.